Hello and welcome to this video. Now I've had a few requests on how best to use Ratskin flesh, what you'll use it for, and what colours are best to both shade and highlight. So in this video we're going to take you through two examples, bronze flesh and tan leather. Now we're going to start with the bronze flesh first, and for this we'll be using Keric Acolyte, which we've undercoated with Wraithbone. Now the first colours we're going to be applying is a base coat of Ratskin flesh. We're then going to apply Fire Slayer flesh all over that, tidy back up with Ratskin flesh, then we'll do some highlighting of Deathclaw Brown, finished off with Kislev flesh. So let's get started. What we need to do first is just get some Ratskin flesh like so on our palette, a little bit of water so it's not too thick and goopy, get our brush to a nice point like so, and then we're ready to start base coating. Just going to do a couple of thin coats on the model like so, and for this I'm using a small layer brush. There we are with the base paint now dry. What we're going to do now is apply Fire Slayer flesh all over that. I'm going to thin it down ever so slightly with a little bit of contrast medium as well, just so it flows better into the recesses. So what I'm going to do is just apply a paintbrush worth of contrast medium, maybe a little bit more because I didn't soak up enough then, and then just a little bit of Fire Slayer flesh as well. Mix that together, get my brush nice and loaded up, and then we're going to start applying that to the muscular areas. So just take your time. If you can, just keep it to the recesses. Doesn't matter if you get on the raised details though. We are going to be tidying up in a minute or two anyway. There we are with the contrast now applied. What we're going to do now is just tidy back up the raised details using Ratskin flesh again. So all I'm doing here is just picking those large areas and just layering over. We're just starting a six pack and work our way up. There we are with that tidy up now done. We're going to move on to the next step, which is to start doing our edge highlight. So we're going to be using Deathclaw Brown here. So I'm just going to be picking out parts of the muscle just around the raised areas where the light's going to catch. Now those might feel like a subtle highlight. Without it, it'll be too much of a jump with the next colour. With the first highlight done, we're now going to finish off with Kislev flesh as a final highlight. So we're just going to really pick those fine edge highlights, mainly where the light's going to catch, just to add some definition to that muscular body of this guy. And there we are with that highlight now done. Our bronze flesh is finished. So what we're going to do now is move on to our next example, which is tanned leather. And for this, we're using Fecula Flyblow, and I've undercoated her with Death Guard Green. Now the colours we're going to be applying, we're going to start with a base coat of Ratskin flesh, and then I'm going to apply Snakebite leather all over, tidy back up with Ratskin flesh, and then finish off with a highlight of Carrick Stone. So let's get to it. So all we need to do here is just get some Ratskin flesh, a little bit of water, so it's not too thick and goopy, get a nice point to our brush like so, and we're ready to start painting. So all I'm going to do is just apply a couple of thin coats, like so. And for this I'm using a small layer brush. With our base coat applied, what we're going to do now is get Snakebite leather and just coat that all over this leather area. Take your time and avoid it pooling in the recesses too much. With that contrast now applied, we're going to use Ratskin flesh again, and we're just going to be starting to relay or highlight some of those raised details. So things like little tears and stuff. When you've got folds in the cloth, you can just use your paint and just pick those out nicely like so. Another thing you can do as well at this point is do some little scratch effects. So if we just go to the bottom here, just like do some little lines like so. Remember to pick out those edges as well. With that layer tidy up now done, what we're going to now do is use Carrick Stone as a final highlight. So you're just looking to get that obviously in the middle so you can see a bit of Ratskin flesh either side. And again, if you need to, just pick out some of those little bits of scratches, and roughed up bits of leather as well. Sometimes around the edges like here, what you could do is just dotting it like so, and that gives it more of a torn kind of ripped feel, which really adds to that like tanned leather feel. There we are with that highlight done, our tanned leather is completed. And these are just a couple of examples of using Ratskin flesh. Just by swapping out the shade or the highlight here and there, you can get some really interesting effects. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own models with Ratskin flesh. And we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.